You've got a big hat that's slowly eating your brain, right? And if you're the only one with a big hat that eats your brain, you might feel bad about that because that's not a good thing. You know, nobody wants a big hat that's going to eat their brain. Maybe you want a big hat, but you'd rather not have one that eats your brain, right? Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to the Dominion Biosyn campaign for Jurassic World Evolution 2. In the last video, we finished off the first campaign mission. And just finished off again very quickly. Got to the mission complete screen, so we should be good to hit continue and find out what happens next. Very exciting. I still haven't seen this, so.
This facility, it's remarkable.
You can say that again.
Let's call it a biosyn sanctuary.
Although that does sound like marketing rather than reality.
Well, reality is the one we make, right?
Even if it isn't accurate.
These dinosaurs are an asset to the world, one we need to share with it. However, we do this on our terms and our timelines.
We've done our best for the dinosaurs and for biosyn. We did our jobs, and we did them well. This is no time to be looking back.
Then we look forward to all the possibilities that we are about to share with the world.
To the future of biosyn genetics.
Spearheaded by Lewis Dodgson, biosyn genetics ushered in a new era of bioengineering, building a utopia for their dinosaur creations. But in the shadows, Dodgson was devising a more sinister plan. They were engineering prehistoric locusts, capable of destroying any crop or farmland not using biosyn seeds. Doctors Ellie Sattler and Alan Grant discovered their plans and infiltrated biosyn's restricted research area. They were able to collect the DNA evidence they needed to prove biosyn's nefarious intent. Attempting to cover his tracks, Dodgson destroyed the evidence, causing a catastrophe in the valley. He would meet his own demise as a raging inferno tore through the area, putting all life at risk. Fortunately, most of the dinosaurs were saved and the fire was contained. The valley, however, remains a scorched landscape in need of healing, with biosyn's legacy left hanging in the balance.
So I talked about being excited about Dodgson losing his mind, but he's just dead. Following a catastrophic fire at the facility and loss of their leadership, the next generation of biosyn genetics are looking to save the dinosaurs trapped at the headquarters and regenerate their environment. Okay, so we've got this new scorched earth landscape, which, yeah, I've never seen before.
I wasn't expecting it to be this bad.
With Dodgson out of the picture, the future could hold something amazing.
Such as?
A permanent, viable home for the dinosaurs.
I like the sound of that, Owen. We do have the experience to take this on.
There's one thing we don't do, it's easy.
You can say that again.
To really get this right, I think we're gonna need some help.
Funny you should mention that. I have just the right people in mind.
When I think about everything, what really gets me the most is seeing these animals injured. The buildings, bank accounts, and egos can be rebuilt, but a dinosaur is a walking miracle of evolution and science.
They really are a miracle, born of science and dogged determination. And sadly, a lot of sacrifice, too.
Now we can't let that be for nothing. Where do we start?
We triage the situation. Find the dinosaurs most in need of medical care and treat them first.
Agreed. Then we focus on repairing what we can. It looks like the fire damage is minimal in some places.
Sounds good. Let's get started.
I guess by some places she means that.
We should get the essential systems back first. Let's start by repairing the hydropower hub.
Yes, right. Energy is the first step towards getting us back up and running.
Exactly. We sort that out, and we get our core buildings operational again.
I'm not allowed in. Oh, that's mean. I want to drive through. Oh, it's pretty cool, you know, whole new trees and new effects with this kind of, like, smoke rising off the ground and, you know, little dabbles of fire. Now I would like a fire effect that I can manually place. That would make me happy, but, it's pretty cool. It's funny that no matter what happens, the missions always go back to the same idea. Yeah, let's make a sanctuary for the dinosaurs. Claire just doesn't have any other ideas. Just, I don't know. I want her to go crazy. Go, yeah, maybe we'll just eat all the dinosaurs, Owen. How did you think about that, did you? Claire's just going to chomp down on a Protoceratops. Because why not, folks? Live your dreams. If your dream's to chomp down on a Protoceratops, then you do it, you know? Don't let society dictate what you're going to do. Much like the Giga, he should be the Joker. You know, he should be the Joker. That'd be another. Those buildings are repairing, right? It's a double check. Yeah, just taking a little bit of time. Good job, buddy.
Claire, I've just received a report about our transport teams. They're grounded for now by the weather. We can't move any dinosaurs captured by the DFW at the moment.
Well, that's not good.
So, what do we do?
Wait for better weather. Why risk anything? You know what happens when we rush something.
Yeah, well, I see your point.
Connect that to that. No? Not connect that to that? Apparently not. Okay. not so sure about that. Usually you connect the control center to the the research lab. Come on. Oh, don't be a cheeky little black. Come on. Oh, yeah, well, you go this way. It's your fault. You could have been at a cool angle. Nah, you're at a stupid angle. Emergency shelter. How do you feel about that? I feel terrible. That's how it feels. To chew. What's that gum called that they have in America? And the advert's like, you're standing on top of a mountain and that's how it feels to chew that gum. That's how you feel right now. I don't know the advert. So it's not the best metaphor at the best of times. Never mind when you don't actually know the advert. It doesn't have power. It's not connected. I don't know. Yeah, so, interesting, right? A whole new thing. We've got this, like, sort of burnt-out shrubbery as well.
Owen, remember when you said we're gonna need help?
Which time? The time the park fell apart? The time we were chased by my own raptors? The time the volcano went off and we had to run down the hill? Well, you rolled, but...
I get it. You know what I meant. Anyways, help has arrived. You remember Dr. Sattler and Dr. Grant?
After all we've been through, yes. Yes, I do.
I just can't believe we're all back here again. How can we help?
Were these always here? Am I crazy?
Right now, we could use some more personnel. Specifically, scientists.
I might know 100 or 200. We're gonna need anyone specializing in paleontology or paleobiology.
Or paleobotany. We pretty much know them all.
You know, it's amazing that a lifetime of studying dinosaurs might just get you noticed, but run from a few, and you're kind of a rock star.
Just grabbing some general people with a slight focus on logistics. Welfare just, plus super expensive. I don't know if money's going to be an issue, but... I'm no longer going to suggest that money's not going to be an issue when money keeps being an issue. A wildfire in Biosyn Sanctuary has left areas of the valley covered in wildlife fouled wild blah 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 blah. That's what it's covered in. I don't make the rules, it's covered in blah 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 blah. wildfire debris. Dinosaurs cannot be comfortably housed until the wild blablabla is cleared. You scientists do clear blablabla so that the dinosaur landscape can be regenerated and inhabited by dinosaurs again.
Allie, why are we here? Really, what are we doing? I promised myself I would never, never get mixed up in this business again. And yet...
I know, but once you see these magnificent creatures, you really feel the history of this planet, its life, its ecosystem. I wouldn't miss that for the world.
I know, but there's always that underlying need to get ready to run.
Well, yes, there is that, but can we just take in the good parts for now? Your life's work is living all around us.
Yep. Still gets my heart beating.
Look at this outcome. Look at these dinosaurs. Don't you wish Ian could be here with us?
No.
Well, we wouldn't let him drive. Now, we've got some debris blocking the dinosaurs. I think if we could open up a path through this part of the facility, the dinosaurs could reach a lot more usable space.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Takes plenty of ages, this.
I'm guessing we could do that by cleaning up this section of scorched earth here. It'll give them a little breathing room, but it won't be easy.
Are you ready for a hard day's work?
Oh, you know me. Ready when you are.
I don't know what scientists have to do with this. I suppose, I mean, scientists would be helpful, but, you know, what we need is, like, we need Dave, basically. Ranger teams can use ascend equipment to command dinosaurs to move to a distant point. Summon equipment commands dinosaurs. Okay, we know this, yeah. Okay.
There's a good stretch of beautiful land in the valley, untouched and perfect for the dinosaurs. But to get them there, we'll need to move the animals through a lot of fire-damaged forest. Here's the path that Ellie and Alan laid out.
Many of the dinosaurs have the instinct to move in herds, in packs. We convince a few and the others will follow, even the solitary animals. Once they see a large migration, they'll be tempted to tag along.
And the predators will go where their food does.
They always do. Okay, how about we mobilize our ranger teams to wrangle them through the path? It'll be like a cattle drive, but with vehicles, and the cows weigh 8 tons.
Wait, what's the marked area? Wait, where do you want me to send these dinosaurs? Because I assumed I was going to move them into here, right? That would be the logical thing to do. Whoa, what are you doing? Can't take you anywhere. Right, I'm just going to try summon and then through the gate. I'm just going to assume this is correct. Come on, you. Come on. Okay, why can't you go through there? You should be enough. I guess this is wrong. All right, let me go grab this one as well. Okay. Go on, everyone. Off on a journey. It's going to be a lot of whistling. Come on. Come on. I don't know where we're going. I thought that was the logical way to go, but... Wait, there's the marker! Game, what do you want from me here? Because the gate won't bloody open. Oh, now it... It literally said that the gate was going to automatically open. It literally said that. I'm not crazy. I should now be able to move through. I was thinking this is going to be really difficult if you can't just take them through the gate. But the gate's meant to auto-open, so I didn't bother to do it. So really, the game is wrong, and I'm very clever. It's the only explanation. That should be it, really. I need to move further along. Yeah, maybe a bit further over that way. Come on, Dino Gang. It's cool that they integrate this into the Chaos Theory and into the campaign. God, I wish these shred notices weren't so slow. Just a really good whistler. That's all there is to it. If you want to be a dino wrangler, all you need to do is whistle. And this would be a lot easier if I just push them. Whistle and hold your hand out, and that's like basically all you need to do. Come on. There we go.
We've made some great progress to this point, Claire.
I completely agree. But we need to keep moving forward. What's next for the dinosaurs?
Research outposts. We can construct or repair what we need.
Great. Let's get on it.
Remember when we first saw the dinosaurs, Alan? When the promise of Jurassic Park was so alive?
Yeah. I was overwhelmed. We all were. And the potential filled me with hope.
It was magic.
It was, Ellie. It truly was.
But like all magic, it was just an illusion. We didn't realize the consequences of bringing them back.
Yeah. We may not be able to change the past, but we can learn from it.
Really? Like when they failed again with Jurassic World?
All that technology. We do not need those elaborate security devices they had. What we do need is more hands-on conservation. Ranger patrols, for instance, that could effectively monitor the animals and their welfare, you know?
Correct. Vigilance.
Exactly.
You okay? Got my fences. Right, sure, dinosaurs have comfort. Can we go? I think. Yeah, I'm okay. Do I need to build the next ranger outpost then? Okay. Oh no. It's fine. God damn it, right, what we need to... Bear with me. Bear with me. There we go, there we go. Right, I get it, I get it. You can't do it. I get it, buddy, I get it. Let's get that status check on the go, shall we? I wanted to check on the, didn't I build a post? Where's my post? I know I built one. There it is. Can you just go bloody do this, please? Ow! Get out of the way. Yeah. No, go away. Thank you. Right. Just clear all the dinosaurs these status checks. Why are you not doing it? Why are you driving away like a numpty? Kids these days can't be trusted. Okay, so, cohabitation issue. Clearly not actually a cohabitation issue, fantastic. Missing ground leaf, we can work on that one, that one's doable. There you go, buddy. Okay, getting there. What about you, Dread? Stats check. Come on. There we go. Missing tall fiber and tall fruit. Not a problem. And forest, apparently. Bloody Nora. There's the fiber. There's the fruit. And then we need more forest. Okay. So, 100% on the dreads, 100% on the stickies, need some ground nut for the paras, 100% for the para, there we go, lovely stuff. You're a very obnoxious little triangle, aren't you? Like an Illuminati kind of thing going on here. Ensure all ranger posts have a ranger team assigned. Well, they do. Don't they? Yeah. What? What? Can we do it again?
If we're going to see real improvement in the health of the animals, we'll need a paleo medical facility.
I'll get right on.
healthier they are, the more content they are going to be.
I knew I'd already done that. That's a bit weird. Okay. It's a beautiful new day. We're going to rebuild the valley. Use our scientists. Get them in the fields, you know. Clearing stuff away. Why not? Actually looks kind of cool. Look at that. Yeah, it's interesting. Hey, I need a good thumbnail. Aw, yeah. Alright. Well, we should just assign it to the ranger post. And then it should go check, and it should check everyone, basically. It's quite handy. This is quite a new feature, I believe. The ability to assign the MVU to ranger posts. And then it just gets automatically assigned to whoever's in the area. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Take your time, buddy. Take your time. No rush. Why can you go? I want to go through there. I want a thumbnail. It looks cool, but I need to be over there. Wait, maybe Ansel can cheat me through. Can Ansel cheat me through? Oh, no, Ansel, no! Ansel, you were so cool. Okay, so we've got disease and we've got injury. Let's see what we're dealing with here. Smoke inhalation. Oh, that makes sense. Enables the dart rifle medication of smoke inhalation with mobile vet units. Okay, let's get that researched. I need a staff building. Can I get a staff building? Let's get that on the go. I'm surprised the game very rarely forces you into a staff building, even though they are 100% necessary. It's quite interesting, actually, how they don't bother. I mean, no, it says some are injured, some are diseased. So all I'm seeing is disease so far. What's going on with you, buddy boy? MVU. Oh, first degree burn. I love that they've changed this. Now, when something gets like a minor. Oh, that looks beautiful. When something gets like a minor injury, like a first degree burn, seemingly, then the MVU. Oh, it's just so pretty. It's just so pretty. And then the MVU automatically dispatches into the area. Pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. We go right. Get some medication on the go. I don't think I need to actually manually sign this, but I feel like I'm committed to the idea, so I'm going to do it anyway. Let's get some speediness, shall we? Zoom. I'm trying to save you, you stupid dinosaur. Just let me shoot you. It's for your own good. Man, this environment is fantastic. And that parasaur is absolutely... This new head model, honestly, is so good. It really is. The head model, the neck, the thickness at the tail of the base. That's where you want your thickness to be, let's be honest. Looks like it's got like a grumpy old man mustache, which is very arousing. That's what I look for in my partners. Okay, there we go. We've only got fuel. Let's get that redone. Let's go check on this injured Dreadnoughtus. What's up, buddy? Carbon monoxide. Ah, oh, blah, blah, blah. It would be the last one I check, wouldn't it? That would be by far the most annoying one. The only one that needs actual movement. If I'd done this one first, it could have been doing it whilst all this other stuff was going on. Come on, you cheeky little player. I am miles away. Wow. Okay.
En route to collect the asset.
Okay. Well, good thing we bought a staff center. We're going to need to train some people up. I'm going to need to hire someone. I mean, I guess it makes sense that you would need high welfare given what this mission is. But I never assume you need high welfare because you so rarely do. That's my bad. I've been punished. I'm a bad boy. What can I say?
Transportation underway.
Dude, so noble, so graceful, so beautiful. Alright. I'm gonna get a new scientist. I mean, that fantastic logistics, but I need welfare now. Five is cool. Anyone higher? Probably don't need higher. Five is fine. So we've got 2 with 5. Unrest limit, both the same. So it's about who we prefer. So we're gonna read that bios. Ombre, Ember, is it Ember or Ombre? Ombre is spelled O-M-B-R-E, but Ember spelled E-M-B-E-R, but that is close. I'm going to go with Ember, or Embre, Embre. Embre found a paleontology school club for fellow dinosaur fans. That's cool. Embre enjoys regular board game nights with their friends, very cool. Embre is a key follower of astrology, much less cool, don't like that at all. Natural explorer Jack applied for a job. Okay, natural explorer, that's cool. Jack likes to go for long walks in the park. Blech. 2 pet dogs, though. Dogs are cool. Jack sang in the school choir twice, reaching the national finals. Blech. So, I've got the astrologist and the glee clubist. I don't want to hire either of these people. Both terrible people. This might sound judgmental, but if I was hiring for a scientist position, right? If you're hiring someone to... For like 99% of jobs, it's absolutely fine. But if you're hiring someone for a factual, science-based position, I feel like believing in astrology is actually quite a problem, in a way. I don't mean that to sound too judgmental, but it's nonsense, right? So, like, how could I hire someone? I don't know. It's the same that, though. I would consider the same of... Again, I'm not trying to be controversial or anything. But, you know, I don't personally follow religion. And there's a lot of religion that you would suspect goes in the face of science. But there's some incredibly competent, incredibly knowledgeable and talented Catholic scientists or Muslim scientists, etc. So, you know what, Embre. I'm going to hire Jack because I know how to... Oh, no, he's more expensive. Although he has, and he's got a higher rate. Okay, Salibi. I'm gonna call you Salibi. She likes board games. Board games are cool. I don't know. How do I do this? Is it here? It's not here yet, is it? It's totally fine to believe in astrology, don't get me wrong. But I do find it a little bit weird to do that and be a scientist. Then again, you know, we saw it with, COVID and stuff, the amount of nurses or the amount of doctors who thought COVID was like a scam, you know. Just because someone's like involved in the area doesn't mean they know anything about the area, really. People can be stupid regardless of their job, so yeah, I'm sorry for doubting you, Sleepy. You know what? I'm sure you'll do a fantastic job. She had very good skills, so. I always feel like you're not allowed to say things. Like, I don't want to insult. I literally don't want to insult anyone. But, you know, I also want to be able to talk about my view on things, I guess. I don't know. Life's confusing. Don't talk. I'm going to be a silent YouTuber. There are some YouTubers who do very well not saying a word ever. I get awkward if I don't talk for about 4 seconds, though. So I don't know if that'll ever be me.
Asset requiring collection.
There we go.
I've just been looking over the site. If we clear out this burned foliage, I believe we can restore the soil to regenerate the plant life we need.
This is your specialty, right, Ellie?
Yeah. Yeah, Owen, I'm a paleobotanist and a soil scientist.
I've got to ask, why plants? Don't you think that dinosaurs are more exciting than ferns and ivy?
I'm in the life-saving business. Our future can be found in the soil.
Point taken. I guess it's easier to... replant mistakes.
Well, I don't make mistakes when it comes to plants. The other things, that's a different story.
Do you know how many of these plants are poisonous to the dinosaurs?
About half.
How do the animals know they're poisonous?
65 million years of evolution, and probably one dinosaur's mistake way back when.
Ah, okay, so what do we need to do next?
Time to clear the burned foliage.
You tell him, Ellie. Flying through this debris.
Okay. We need everyone on their toes.
Copy that.
So when are the dinosaurs from the DFW arriving?
Should be any minute by now.
Yeah, overall, I'm happy that the enclosures are in good shape.
The transport teams are back online, ready to go.
Good. Because it's about to get busy. These animals need us. And thanks to our efforts, the valley is back.
Step one, we need to get all the new dinosaurs into the enclosures.
And step two is to not get Aiden in the process.
Okay, listen up. For the health of the dinosaurs, we need to keep all of the animals from the DFW quarantined away from the others, because if we're not careful, we run the risk of spreading viral infections, okay?
Yeah, like that's never happened before.
That's my guy. More saving the day.
Asset transportation complete.
Zoom. Oh, I can't do that one. Zoom in. Can't do any of those.
Asset delivery confirmed.
It's like bloody ages, this. Look how small this brush is. It's so teeny tiny. I need a big chunky brush. Grrg. It reminds me of, if we ever got access to this in Sandbox, maybe some talented people out there will be able to make that happen. We could recreate, like, Prehistoric Planet with the Troodontid in the forest fire. That'd be awesome, actually. Got that fixed. Okay, so Stego's gonna live here. Oh, Stego already does live here. Get you a ranger outpost. We're gonna put Carnotaurus over here. We're gonna put Ankylosaurus over there. How are we doing, Stego? Well, obviously we need lots of things. Okay, fiber, ground nut, a little bit of water. Shum, 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 there we go. Now you can't live with Ankylosaurus, can you? No, I didn't think so, okay. We do need to keep them all separate. Carnotaurus.
Boop. Asset has been corrected.
Give it a live prey feeder. Get you a bit more water. There's no tea and water. People try to convince me otherwise. Those people are wrong. Come on, fire crew. What are you doing? Hurry up. I can't do any of the others. All my stuff suck. So what's going on over here? Why are you connected? I don't need to be connected. That's the whole point of the Hyperloop. I can't do anything, can I? I can't train anyone. No, it's fine. We'll wait. As long as there's room for the Anki. I mean, he's going to have to live in a bit of a nightmare, but it is what it is.
Asset delivered.
At the end of the day, we all live in a bit of a nightmare, folks. What are you going to do? A bit of sand, a bit of forest. Go! Happy, happy dinosaurs! Except this one. It's going to be a bit of a problem. Hurry up! My god! Right, come on, Ankies. I'm sorry.
Asset transit. Asset transportation underway.
How long does it take to just save the world? People are slacking. Nearly.
Asset transported.
Let's get that fixed.
Asset has been transported.
Get this. What's this one look like? Let's do this one. This one's a bit darker. It's pretty cool. But it's kind of like, it's hard to see at nighttime, but it's got this kind of like bobbly kind of texture to it. It looks wibbly wobbly. Bibbly bobbly. I'm pretty sure whenever they made this texture, the game director, the artist for this was like, you know what we need? He's talking to the texture designer, obviously. We need a wibbly wobbly, bibbly bobbly texture. And the artist's like, yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. My specialty. Because my name is Bob. It is wibbly wobbly, bibbly wobbly. Okay. I will stop talking now. Right, a bit of forest. I wish this expanded quicker. Because there's plenty
look
of bloody forest.
Place. Just look at the transformation. It's astonishing. Makes me remember why I got into all of this in the first place.
I still wonder what led me here to this moment. Idealism?
It's not a bad thing, Claire.
It actually can be a great thing. A great motivator.
You're right. So what's left?
We need to treat the injuries and diseases of the animals from the DFW.
Now that sounds like a job for an idealist.
Sign uses these posts. Whatever. Let's find out. You took your blimit. Right, it's because I've not named you. How can someone be expected to work if they're not given the true love that being called Drive Bobies gives to them, you know? Where are you? People are such slackers. everyone happy? Missing water. Well, I mean, it's your own bloody fault. And the fox. Just walk a little further. You'll be fine. Kids these days, honestly. Alright, what's going on here? Okay, we need to take a photo. Can I? No, okay. Come on, Bobies. This car is a disaster. Take a photo. Zoom in. Beautiful. National Geographic, right there. Research available for rabies. Oh my god, everyone's got rabies. It's like in real life. Is that all it is? It's just everyone's got rabies? Yeah, everyone's got rabies. Cool. It's nice, you know. They've all got rabies together, though. It's kind of like if you've got a really big hat, for example, you might feel... one of my better metaphors. If you've got a really big hat, you might feel a little bit ashamed about your big hat because nobody else is wearing this big hat, right? If you're the only one with the big hat, then you're kind of going to... Wait, why are you going all the way over there? If you're the only one with a big hat, you're going to kind of feel like you stand out a little... What are you doing? You're going to stand out a little bit too much with your big hat. So it's nice sometimes to meet other people with big hats. So then you can feel more confident about your big hat. You know what I mean? Even if... Okay, no, it's not the best example. Okay, you've got a big hat that's slowly eating your brain, right? And if you're the only one with a big hat that eats your brain, you might feel bad about that because that's not a good thing. You know, nobody wants a big hat that's going to eat their brain. Maybe you want a big hat, but you'd rather not have one that eats your brain, right? But if everyone else, or like you had a group of friends who also all had big hats that ate your brain, you'd feel a little bit better about it because shared misery is very helpful. You know what I mean? It's the same thing with rabies, basically. Which is harsh because rabies has largely been eradicated, so. Oh, my. Sorry, I need a beverage.
Sometimes I even amaze myself.
Sometimes?
As in sometimes I wonder how I even survived all this.
We all wonder that. But let's focus on the facility. Now that it's rebuilt, we need to make sure it can be maintained.
What if we monitor the status of the dinosaurs? We keep them disease-free?
And then our work should be done.
I wasn't sure we'd ever get this place back under control.
Think we could call this a success?
As long as the dinosaurs are comfortable? I think so.
Then it's time to test the system. Make sure it's stable and viable. Let's keep our dinosaur comfort and visibility ratings high. Make that our top priority. That and...
And not getting eaten. Yep, I know.
So, how are we doing, Ellie?
It's no Isla Nublar, that's for sure.
Well, that's certainly something to be thankful for.
I just meant the conditions here at Biosyn are more challenging. The climate, the biodiversity, the lack of natural barriers. It all adds up.
You're right. But tell me, has adversity ever stopped you before?
No, but it's getting harder with each challenge. We have got to get it right, or this could all fall apart.
Well, we certainly don't want that. You will be fine, though. You can identify and solve problems like nobody else I have ever met.
Really?
Really.
flattery, Dr. Grant?
No, that's the truth. But... sure.
Well, any trace of scorched earth has got to go. The remnants of this location's violent past need to be erased. For good.
Then that is precisely what we will do. Together.
Hello, buddy. Pal, just turn slightly to your right. Oh, this wildfire thing takes so long. Come on. There we go. No! Craig, why? Why have you betrayed me like this? Okay. Positive influence, okay. Alright, that's the last one. Oh, yeah, and it counted. That's nice. I'm just gonna give someone a rest. Want me to close it? Oh, I did it. Okay.
Even when they're at their most brutal, their most terrifying, the dinosaurs are still beautiful.
Dodgson misunderstood the true potential of this place.
Dodgson, he was wrong on so many levels.
Hopefully this time, we've learned from the past.
And the dinosaurs have as well. They know the Earth is theirs and that they belong here.
But it should be ours together. Humanity and dinosaurs. Call me an optimist, but I think we can make it work.
How so?
We all have a choice. And the dinosaurs do too. Coexistence, it can work. But only if all of us are prepared to embrace it.
I've got to say, Owen, it's hard to argue with that.
No, it's not. The dinosaurs can't all get together and say, all right, Rex, all right, Raptors, all right, all you who want to eat people, or Therizinosaurus who wants to go slap Claire. You know, be cool, bro. Be cool, okay? Just, I need to calm down. We're not going to fight the humans anymore. And then every dinosaur on the planet just goes, you know what? Yeah, fair point. We'll be chill. Look at that, 100%. 100%. 5%. Ignore this. You saw nothing. Right, well, that is the end of the campaign. How do I feel about the campaign? It was a decent length. It took, you know, 2 hours plus, which is like half the length of the original campaign. I know people are still a little bit disappointed by the original campaign. I think a lot of us thought that this was going to get expanded because it felt short. I don't think we'll get anything else. I think the campaign is probably done forever now. I think this is probably as far as this ever goes. I mean, we had Claire's and we had Dr. Wu's. I don't know what they would do, though, I guess. I guess we didn't know what they would do with Dr. Wu or with Claire. They can kind of just... well, Claire's made sense. Claire's folded into Fallen Kingdom. Dr. Wu's kind of folded into Jurassic World to an extent, but not really. They could just make up a storyline, right? It wouldn't be that big a deal. It'd be nice to see that continue to expand with more DLC. Because I quite like the campaigns. I think it's a nice way to mix it up. Because otherwise I just build sandbox parks. You know, it's nice to have a little bit more variety. I should try challenge mode. I am tempted by, I think, probably the Jurassic Park one. Because I believe this is... I need to double check the list, but... there's one of them that's got intelligent dinosaurs, and it sounds really interesting. And we've never really done challenge mode, so I might try like a hard challenge mode or something at some point. But yeah, the campaign was fine. It was nice to use the new mechanic. The clearing out the debris was interesting. I mean, it wasn't interesting in a gameplay sense, because all I did was click on it and it cleared. But in terms of visual design, it was interesting. I like the new wrangling. I think that should have been in the campaign more. It's in the chaos theory a bit more. It's the thing the game needs more than anything. Well, what the game needs more than anything else is new attractions, as we've said many times now. But beyond that, new mechanics and new ways of interacting with the game world are quite an important thing. So I don't think I'm ever going to use that wrangling mechanic again. I just don't see myself using it in, say, Sandbox. Maybe in Challenge, you never know. But I doubt it. But it's still another way. It's there if I wanted to use it. And if I wanted to interact with the world in that way, I have that option. And that's, I really like that. And I wish we had more stuff like that. I want a first-person shooter mode. Anyways, that's the campaign. Let me know what you thought in the comment section down below. And, oh yeah, I should talk about Horror Park. I know I said I'd record it before the DLC came out, but I didn't. Because I had early access to the DLC and I knew I had so much to do, so I had to get started ASAP. I don't want to load it right now. I'm kind of scared that if I load it, everything will break. So I'm just waiting, and the mod tools have not been updated because mod tools, the Frontier absolutely broke the modding, basically, with this latest update. So I'm basically waiting now till the mod tools update, until, you know, Kyle's mods are updated for the new version. Then I'm going to load them all in, and hopefully we'll get Horror Park finished. In the meantime, we'll play some challenge, maybe do another build on the side, and play other games. We're going to play some Prehistoric Kingdom this week. Thank you very much for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.